Hey guys, welcome back to Let's Play Xanadu. So, our armor is now officially upgraded to God mode. Wow, hey, these guys can actually still hurt us a little bit. So yeah, we really shouldn't have taken these guys on before, because if they can hit us for 150 hit points now, that meant our previous armor, we would have gotten murdered. So yeah, what's next? I guess we'll carry on killing a bunch of these guys. Let's see, what else? Oh yeah, I was going to show you the hidden area of level 2. So let's do that next. And I'll even get to showcase a special item to help us get there. So yeah, ever since we went into level 2 and 3, we managed to pick up a bunch more special items, which let us sort of manipulate our presence. No, we don't want to upgrade our levels yet. We'll do that later. And yeah, let me show you one of them right now. So first we have to get all the way back to level 1 in order to get to the hidden area of level 2. And we can do that by kind of taking the long way here, but that's okay. Going down here and going back into the level 1 area. And once we're back in level 1, we have to go all the way to the top again. I really like how our new armor is looking. The shoulder pads and the little cross, yeah, makes me feel a little bit more safe. So we'll go in here, all the way up here. Now there's a way to get here without the special item, but it's very tricky and it takes forever and I've never been able to do it properly, so yeah, whatever. The correct way would be to stand on here, to keep jumping until you get up to 2 height, and if you time it just right, you'll be able to jump onto this thing up here. But like I said, I've never been able to do it properly, so I'm just going to take a shortcut. And to take this shortcut, you need some of the items you find in the towers in level 2. Specifically, you need the mattock, which is item number F, which is basically a kind of pickaxe. And what this allows you to do is it allows you to destroy parts of this blue wall that you keep seeing everywhere. To do it, you climb up next to the wall where you that you want to destroy. You move up one space, and then you face in the direction of the wall. And then you press enter to use it like any other item. And what it does, as you can see right here, is it makes a hole, which you can pass through. So instead of having to do all the annoying jump tricks to get up here, we can actually just walk through this newly made hole and get into the secret area up here. And you can see the portal right below me that leads to the hidden area of level 2. So let's go in there right now. And first thing I'll do is I'll re-equip my lamp because we're going into a tower. Oh yeah, and there's an assassin bug running around here as well, so we can kill him off too for a little bit of extra gold, I guess. I think they drop mirrors or something. Yeah. And this tower is just a tower like any other. It has a special looking door, but it's really no different than any of the other towers. I looked this up, by the way. There's no end boss for level 2. So the Kraken from level 1, you don't actually get one of those guys at the end of every level. This kind of looked like the tower that would have the end boss, but I knew I never found it back in the day. But I figured I was just not very good at this game. But I looked it up, and actually there's no such thing as a level 2 boss. Some levels don't have bosses at all, and some of them have more than one. I think the final level has like a bunch of them. Okay, so that's the Krakens killed. Let me just check my map that I made earlier to see where we're supposed to go. I guess it doesn't matter much. We'll do the right side first. Left side first. Yeah, there's a couple of locked doors in this tower that we're gonna need to get rid of, but nothing too tricky. Assassin bugs are one of those guys that used to be pretty dangerous, but now that we have our armor upgrade, these guys aren't going to touch us. Same is true for the guys, I think, in the next room, is that right? Yep. There's ravens in the next room, who normally would be very challenging. But we got our armor upgrade, so they can't really hit me anymore. There we go. There's nothing really too spectacular in this tower. It's mostly just items like this metal over here, which are valuable, but they're not too, we're not going to get too excited about them. No special stuff like the strength upgrade in the level 1 tower or anything like that. And as you can see, our experience with the battle axe is also getting better. We're up to 10,000 damage per hit now, so yeah, that's pretty impressive. That'll take care of almost any kind of monster for the first level 1 through 4 or 5 at least, in a single hit. So we won't be needing to upgrade our weapon for some time. And the same is now true for our armor, so the only thing we're really going to be worrying about is our magic spells. Another demon's ring. The way these demon's rings are placed in the towers, almost makes you think like they're really valuable, but honestly, I don't think I've ever really used them. Some more hoods. And I think after we clear this tower, we'll clear the towers from level 3. I guess we'll see after that, I don't know. Plenty of lamps. Can never have too many lamps. Oops, I accidentally picked one up right away there. And two Maddocks, which is definitely worth wasting two keys on. Some poison. I'm going to leave it here because, like I said earlier, poison is actually going to be useful to us at some stage, probably. So I'm going to want to leave some of those for later. And the reason they are useful is because there's actually another statistic in your character sheet that I haven't really talked about earlier, which is KRM under agility and next to magic resistance. I'm at zero now, which is good. You always want to keep it at zero as much as you can. KRM is short for karma. And in the higher levels, starting with level 3, you can actually run into monsters that are considered good in the context of the game. And what that means is that if you kill them, you get karma. And as soon as you get even a single point of karma, you won't be able to level up until you get rid of it. And the only way to get rid of karma is by drinking poison. So it's kind of a self-sacrifice thing that if you willingly drink poison, then your karma improves again. Just as a kind of atonement for killing the good monsters. Yeah, it's kind of weird, and it can really screw up your game if you don't have any poison left in the levels you've been. So, yeah, it can be a little bit annoying, but that's the reason why you want to save a bunch of poison for later. Just in case you pick up some karma somewhere and you don't have an old save game or anything where you can go back and restart the level or something. Go kill some more hoods. Another Maddock. Maddocks are really valuable because in the item shop they cost, I think, 10,000 gold, which is obviously quite a lot. And yeah, they just let you get into places where you normally would have trouble getting into. They especially can help you save a bunch of keys to get through to places where normally you might need a couple of keys. You can just use a Maddock to destroy the walls and get in there right away. Let's see. I think we want to go up here. Yep, I think so. But we'll kill this guy first. There we go. Brown potion. Don't really remember what that does. Doesn't matter too much. Some of the weak krakens, which only give us a balance, which I think improves your dexterity, which is almost completely useless. In fact, I think in the next trip up to the king, I'm going to sell some of our more useless items just to get some extra gold. Haven't done so far, but mostly because they're not very valuable, they don't give you a lot of gold. But might as well, if we're not going to use them anyway. Especially that balance, I don't think I've ever used a balance in the history of the game. Get some more experience for our X. Check real quick how our... Oh, we're almost at 200 already. So yeah, our X is quickly nearing our maximum experience. But, well, as you can see, it does so much damage that really we don't need to upgrade for some time. Kill some more hoods down here, and that'll almost be the end of this tower. I think we've gotten almost every single room now. Which is good, because I think we're also coming up on our time limit. In fact, I might already be over it. Just clean out the final room, and we'll cut off the video there. There we go. And this door will get us to the exit. I'm afraid we'll have to waste one more key. There we go, that's the end. Okay guys, once again, thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.